During dispatch, we haven't considered a situation when more than one instruction is ready to execute, so let's do that. So here's a situation where we have a similar broadcast to the previous case, where we have, you know, reservation station 1 is broadcasting a result of -0.29. So we're still gonna free reservation station 1 as before. We will still gonna capture all of the results, that hasn't changed. So here we're gonna latch -0.29. This doesn't need to match anything here because we already have a value. Here we're gonna also latch 0.29, and here we're gonna do the same thing. But now we have a situation where for the multiplication and divide unit, it's pretty clear that this is the instruction that gets to execute. So this is easy. But here we need to choose between one of these two, because assuming that the other can only handle one instruction per cycle, we need to pick one of these. And now we have to figure out which one. So there needs to be some logic that's going to pick one of these instructions, because both of them cannot go. Now we need to figure out, you know, are there any good rules about which one should go first? So our question is basically, should we dispatch RS1 or RS2? Well, ideally, we will dispatch that instruction that allows us to kind of get to future instructions as early as possible. So basically, we would choose the instruction that leads to the highest performance. Unfortunately, that requires knowledge of the future, and this is something that hardware is pretty bad at doing, because we only can really look here at these instructions here and maybe the next couple of instructions in the instruction queue, while in reality, the situation might change because, for example, this instruction might have a lot of dependent instructions later on, and this one might have few, but we don't know that until we see those a lot of instructions later on. So it's very difficult to decide that based on kind of perfect knowledge of the future. So how do we choose this instruction? Well, there are some heuristics. So basically, we cannot really do a perfect job of it, but we can make some reasonably good guesses. One choice that usually makes a lot of sense is oldest first. So pretty much whichever of these instructions has been sitting here longer will be allowed to go first. Why? Well, because for an older instruction, all other things being equal, it's more likely that more instructions are by now waiting for it. Simply, you know, if an instruction is older, by now you could have seen more instructions that will use its values. And also this allows us to kind of, you know, mark off some instructions as done. So basically, oldest first is a typical heuristic that gets done this way. Another one that could be used is something like most dependencies first, where we would check how many other instructions need the value from each one of these, and then use the one, I mean, you know, dispatch the one that will kind of free up the most of the other instructions. But this one would be this heuristic would be difficult to implement because we would have to actually like search a lot of stuff, which is going to be very power hungry and so on. So typically, if we do anything, we will just do the oldest first. Another choice would be to just randomly select the instruction, like, for example, whichever comes first in order of reservation stations or something like that. So something that has nothing to do with their age in the reservation station or whoever has most dependencies. This strategy would also work, because note that if we don't send the oldest first, we will eventually run out of things to do, because all of the things will depend on the oldest instruction, at which point it will run. So basically, it's not a problem regarding correctness if we choose something other than oldest first or dependence first. It's just an issue of kind of what works reasonably well. So typically oldest first does help somewhat with like releasing instructions from here, while, you know, random is okay as far as just, you know, correctness is concerned. So pretty much any one of these three would work. It's just a matter of, you know, which one would lead to the best performance. And we kind of choose an oldest first as a kind of compromise between what we have to look at and, you know, what gives us good performance. So random would give us kind of the worst performance. This would give us the best performance, but this is relatively easy to do, so we kind of compromise between the two.